के ऊपर मेरे ऊपर बोलने की क्यों कोशिश करते हैं?
एक्सक्यूज मी, दिस इज माई स्टूडियो, माई प्रोग्राम, व्हाई यू बदर मी सो मच?
आई वॉन्ट टू मीट आलतू बाबा, ही इज द इंस्पिरेशन फॉर दिस प्रोग्राम टू गेट सूटेबल वधूस इन द बे एरिया। और तो और, हमने कैंडिडेट से पैसा भी ले लिया कि आलतू बाबा से मीट एंड ग्रीट कराएंगे।
वो क्या, बट आलतू बाबा इतनी इजिली हाथ में नहीं आएगा माँ, वो पूरा बदन पे तेल लगा के घूमता है वो। वो कोई पकड़ेगा तो ये खिसक जाएगा।
बट आपने बोला था प्रोड्यूसर जी कि बेर या पकपक आलतू फालतू के साथ है तो आप कुछ अरेंजमेंट करेंगे।
हाँ हाँ हाँ, बनाएगा मीटिंग ग्रीट, बनाएगा, डेफिनेटली बनाएगा। आप एक काम करो, ये साइन करके हमें दे दो, हाँ वहाँ जाके बैठ जाओ। ओके, अभी हम स्टार्ट करेगा। ए राजा, पुंगी बजा रहे। नमस्कार।
नमस्ते।
नमस्कार।
वणक्कम।
खुशामदीन।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
सत्यकाल।
हमारे शाम के सफर के दोस्तों के लिए और बेरिया के सारे फीजियंस को हमारे तरफ से एक प्यार भरा निसाम बुला।
मी कंदरे की वंदनमु।
जय राम जी की।
हम आ गए
और छा गए
और आपके दिलों को भर गए। We are back
with more back to back buck back.
ये शो है बे एरिया बक बक,
अ महिमा क्रिएशंस प्रोडक्शन।
इस शो बे एरिया बक बक में रोमांस है, एक्शन है, ट्रेजेडी, सस्पेंस, थ्रिल्स, चिल्स, मिले या ना मिले लेकिन चीप थ्रिल्स एंड कॉमेडी डेफिनेटली मिलेगी। तो कुवारी लड़कियाँ
अपने दिल थाम के बैठिए
और शादीशुदा औरतें
अपने पति को थाम के बैठिए
और पास लाइए
अपने रेडियो को
और संभालिए अपने
दिल को,
क्योंकि रोक ना पाएंगे
अपने आप को
जब सुनेंगे हमारे
प्रोग्राम को।
दिल है आपका दीवाना क्या, आलतू फालतू का है ये अफसाना क्या, रेडियो सुन के जब झूमे है मन, हिचकिचाना घबराना क्या, रेडियो बजाओ फोन लगाओ, फोन लगा के ये खुल के कहो, इट्स द टाइम टू बक बक, इट्स द टाइम टू बक बक।
आपके लिए फिर से एक और बार, और यस आज है कोविड 19 शेल्टर इन प्लेस डे नंबर 32, 32 राइट?
हाँ
32, ब तो 30 के ऊपर दो ब दो तो 32 बज जाए। लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग, आज ऑफ कोर्स वी गेटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द इकोनॉमी गोना ओपन अप एंड एवरीथिंग, एंड इस टाइम में काफी सारे जगह पे आल्सो यू नो धरना चल रही है टू ओपन द इकोनॉमी अर्लियर बिकॉज पीपल अफेक्टेड एंड एवरीथिंग। आई अंडरस्टैंड आल्सो सेफ्टी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट जन द समथिंग आई वांट टेल फालतूनी पीपल, यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड दिस वेरी मच, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पीपल अंडरस्टैंड दिस, यू नो व्हाई? Because people think wealth is everything.
Huh.
अरे यार health है तो wealth है यार, वरना there's no point in, okay people you might say oh that only applies to one strata of the you know social strata.
Uh-huh.
I don't think it's applies to only, it applies across the whole economic strata I should say, because if you don't have health how will you even work?
True.
And I understand, I totally feel the pain of people who actually are, you know, who really are working on the day wages part of it and who are gig workers.
Huh.
I do understand their plight and everything, but at the same time, if you don't have the health later on, what's the point in suffering on it, right?
Right.
You remember what happened in the time of 1918, right? When Philadelphia had the plague or something, they had something, right, at that time? You remember?
Philadelphia?
Yeah, one of those places, there was a big thing. And then they said, okay, you know what, just to increase the...
Oh, you mean the Spanish flu?
Oh, the no, Spanish flu. Spanish flu, yeah. 1900, right? 1914, something like that, right? 1914, that's whatever time, the time, right? There's a story actually which came out about that was saying that there actually was a situation where they actually said, okay, you know what, let's all bring them back. Let's do a big parade for people.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll just to bring up the morale of people to again reignite the economy.
Right.
It did happen. People went on the streets. There were thousands and rows of people who came out on the streets and everything. And finally, they realized the next day, all the hospital beds of the Philadelphia actually were... occupied by a patient, and I think the 4,500 people or something in that range.
Wow.
Got the flu and died.
Oh my God.
So, what I'm trying to say, I'm not saying that it's going to repeat itself. I'm just going to say that, you know, we've got to be cautious about these things. Respect the people who actually are doing this thing, trying to get ourselves, get us in a safe position. That's our authorities and everything. They're doing a good job. We got to support them however we can. Lekin, that doesn't mean we've got to stop having fun. So, we're here with our Bay Area Buck Buck for training. And आज ऑफ कोर्स बेरिया बक बक में बक बक होता रहेगा तो आपको अगर कॉल करें तो नंबर इज 408-912-2479 आपके बारे में देयर इज वन नंबर टू कॉल हियर व्हिच इज 408-912-2479 दिस नंबर इज समथिंग व्हिच एनीबॉडी एंड एवरीबॉडी फ्रॉम अराउंड द वर्ल्ड कैन गिव अस अ कॉल हियर राइट अगेन एक बार बोलूंगा आप लोगों को मुझे फिर ऑन फेसबुक यू सी द नंबर ऑन आवर पेज राइट देयर जस्ट डाउन हियर चेक इट आउट 408-912-2479 408-912-2479 तो आज का बेरिया बक बक Father, I was thinking we should do something about Bollywood only, but we'll talk about something different angle of Bollywood. Think of Bollywood mein kya hota hai, we have for the past 10 years, humne isko ragad ke aisa shining kar diya hai.
Right.
Everybody think it is gold.
Right.
But actually, you know, not everything which glitters is gold, I should say.
Correct.
And Indian cinema, when it started off, almost 110 years ho gaya hai. God bless, there were people who actually, families have been there trying to keep it going for us, the Kapoor families. When they went bankrupt, they still kept it going because they believed in the whole concept of storytelling, I think, suppose. And that particular art form overtook the most age-old art form of drama.
That's true.
Theater has been there for ages, Bhattacharya. And you can imagine how movies have overtaken the theater and has such a big mass appeal that, you know, there's a whole industry which is actually getting the rosy roti from this. And shutdown actually is not helping them also. Please understand one thing, like how we have support systems here in America, it is not so in India. And unfortunately, there are many people who actually are trying to do their best to support the workers. But kaise hoga? We don't know about it. And so many of our stars actually are saying that okay, they're going to share some of their thing into it or they're going to support their organizations. Dekhte kya hota hai uske baare mein, we'll give you more information about that. But the point I'm making over here is that is a big, big, huge industry, right? It didn't start like this. It was not like this at all. It started off with basic stuff. You know what they did, right? Initially.
What did they do?
Indian cinema actually started doing whatever dramas were doing. So drama jo bhi karte the, right? Jo hota tha, usui ko leke, just to make a movie out of it.
Oh.
No, it was the easiest formula to do.
Right.
And it was not just in Hindi cinema. Every other regional cinema is also the same thing. They took dramas and they put the drama into it. And if you notice, in those days, like, you know, 1913 is the earliest movie, as I remember, of Indian cinema, which actually had the storylines also of the same Puranic dramas.
Right.
Raja, Satya, Harishchandra, all the stuff, right? And then the archetype came out of a hero and a heroine.
Correct.
Right? Now, there's been many blame given to Indian cinema, which I think I also have to blame. Because what happens is, when business start doing creative work, businessmen don't understand creativity. They understand only formula.
That is absolutely
so
true.
So, Indian cinema started getting funded by the business world. And the business community wanted formula. So, we got into a formula production. Boy, we've done shows about this. In fact, Pam Pam Show, we've done so many shows where we talked about the concept of how... the formula of Indian cinema, very simple formula: boy meets girl, girl meets boy, boy meets boy falls in love with girl, girl is from high rich family, boy is from rich family, they have conflict,
yeah,
and the resolution.
So
those are the kind of movies. Majority of the movies in Indian cinema are that only. Majority of Indian cinema, if you look at it, like, in almost 80% of Indian cinema is just that. Love is the conflict.
हाँ, हमेशा ऐसे होता है, बिकॉज कुछ तो होना चाहिए, राइट? देयर शुड बी अ हैप्पी मोमेंट, अप and then there should be a breakup down. फिर झगड़ा करके they come back and then you leave with a feel good feeling.
Correct.
या तो या दूसरी चीज ये थी कि वो जो हीर रांझा वाले stories which are like the Romeo Juliet type, they will never unite. They will unite in death.
Yeah, so they were like a pretty much. So if you look at every other movie, is a kind of a flavor of that. So उसी formula को लेके तड़का लगा के पेश कर दिया. उस formula में क्या करेंगे? एक आजकल के ज़माने में six pack लड़के को लेते हैं और एक zero figure की लड़की को देते हैं, mix कर देते हैं. That's what's happening nowadays, right?
हाँ, और बीच में एक और बंदा या बंदी आ जाता है.
Yes. Who will be the villain or sometimes the negative role?
And it'll be a good-looking villain mostly.
आजकल के ज़माने में. But the thing is, there have been people who are, because the creative line, creativity cannot be contained.
Yeah.
Is what I strongly believe. My image is always say, when your creativity is, when there's creativity, nothing can stop it from coming out. It'll automatically come out. Mm-hmm. Is what she's saying. And she said, like, you know, don't worry about anything else. अगर आपके आपके दिल में सच्चाई है, you do something creatively, just do it.
Mm-hmm.
And don't have to call it creativity, just do it. Is what she's saying. And that's what people in industry have been doing. And we want to talk about the fact that, you know, there are movies, mm-hmm, Indian cinema which actually have broken the mold.
Yes.
Right? And now we have to either call these movies as trendsetting movies,
mm-hmm,
or we call them as offbeat movies, mm-hmm, or we call them as something else. I don't know. What kind of term can you call them, Falthorni?
Trendsetting movies.
Now, trendsetting movies are those which actually breaks a certain mold,
uh-huh,
and sets a trend for other people to follow. Right?
Not yes.
A trendsetting movie.
Yes.
And then there are movies which actually are totally... Now, again, trendsetting movies, when they're breaking a mold, can also mean, something like... Okay, trendsetting movies are movies which actually are... They come in and it makes a big, hit and it goes out. Like, for instance, multi-starrer movies.
Hmm.
We did this some time ago on our shows last week on our COVID shows. We talked about multi-starrer movies. Remember?
Correct.
And multi-star movies actually was a trend-setting movie. So one of the biggest multi-star movie talked about also, this is a trivia for everybody out there. What is the first ever multi-star movie of Indian cinema?
The first ever multi-star movie?
Matlab, going back in time. First ever multi-star movie of Indian cinema. We talked about it. We played a beautiful song from the movie. I even talked about the fact that there were not like one, not like two. There were like three or four heroes.
Four heroes.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it was a good movie. It was a nice movie about all the dynamics of relationships and everything. So, now that was again, I would say, a trendsetter movie, because uske baad mein bahut sare films aaye, which were multi-starred, because they said, okay, probably we can duplicate the process, the box office performance of that particular multi-starred movie. We'll do it over there.
Correct.
So, aajkal bhi aise chal rahi hai. Now, I'll play a song of a particular movie, Banuja, which actually is, in my terms... I would say a trend-setting movie.
Okay.
Right? It is a path-breaking movie because, uh-huh, of multiple things.
Okay.
Now, Falthorni, I'll leave it to you. You got to tell me more about the movie. And if you want to ask a question about the movie, what do you think?
Okay. I will ask... Well, it's up to you because we don't have too much time. So, let's cover as many movies as we can.
Okay.
Right?
So, here's the thing. So, I'm going to play a song. We're not going to ask question about this. I'm just going to play a song for you guys to enjoy the song. It's a beautiful song. Shankar-san composition.
Shankar-san.
Law composition. And this actually is... why it is a trendsetting movie, I'll tell you in just a few minutes. But enjoy the song. We'll be back right after this. And aaj ka Bay Area Bugpack is talking about trendsetting movies in Indian cinema. Manajan.
That kind of changed the path of Indian cinema.
I will tell you how also.
दिल चाहता है कभी ना बीते चमकीले दिन। दिल चाहता है हम ना रहे कभी यारों के बिन। दिन दिन भर हो प्यारी बातें झूमे शामे दिन। ओ, ओ, ओ,
लगाते हैं चिल मिलाते हैं अपने रास्ते ये खुशी रहे रोशनी रहे अपने वास्ते चमकाते हैं चिल मिलाते हैं अपने रास्ते ये खुशी रहे रोशनी रहे अपने वास्ते जाए जो हम चाहें वो हम पाए मस्ती में रहे डूबा डूबा हमेशा सवार हमको राहों में यूं ही मिलती रहे खुशियां चाहता है सोचो तो हर एक ही बेखबर है उसको जाना किधर है जो वक्त आए जाने क्या दिखाए
well, जैसे ही गाना लगा था, everybody like, oh my God, it's so true, right? Because I think this is the time when movies actually started relating to people's life a little bit at least.
Yeah.
And why I'm saying little bit, there was no superhuman strength of a hero.
Huh.
There was no, you know, the million-dollar figure of a particular heroic concept.
Right.
Like, you know, heroine was like, oh, goody-goody, lovey two shoes and all that, you know, learning how to learn to dance and everything, right?
Right.
All the kind of stuff, no.
Huh.
And it was nice. It was just plain, simple, fun kind of movie. Everybody would want to do it and would be able to do it also.
And it also very subtly touched upon, you know, fragility in friendships and egos. As we grow older, how egos come into play and how...
And how silly it is after you realize in retrospect, right?
Yeah,
things,
yeah.
You do things in the moment, rush of the moment, like, you know, you fight out somebody and later you realize, oh, what a stupid thing, and you should not have actually done that.
Yeah.
All the kind of stuff talked about the movie, that's why I like the movie. I think that's why the movie is transcendent, because iske baad mein fatah, if you look at it, right, tikri ka bahut ahmiyat rahi hai.
Uh-huh.
Indian cinema, right?
This was excellent entertainment again, right?
Excellent entertainment.
This is Farhan Akhtar's directorial...
Correct, his debut. And then there was also the movie of Zindagi Naam Milegi Dobara again, Tikdi, right? Again, a book hit, became a big hit.
Yeah.
And many movies came out that way as Tikdis, right?
Yeah. And also, you know, there were a lot of... what happened was, cinema went from being melodrama to completely like dishum Salman Khan in 80s 90s wale style, and Akshay Kumar like beating up villains and then wearing those baggy pants and doing to a little more sensible cinema where it was really, in this movie I don't think there was any dishum, was there?
There was a little bit of dishum where he gets beat up by the brother of Priti Zinta.
Yeah, something like that. That's so it, yeah. You saw a change in trends as this happened, and then of course kafi sare movies aise dekha jaye to which path-breaking movies, some movies that come to mind. Of course, unfortunately, we don't have enough time today, but we will. We promise you we will bring you a full-fledged show on this particular thing because the next hour is Geet Gaata Chal. Lekin ek aur movie jahan pe Farhan Akhtar debuted. Did he debut with this movie or did he debut?
His acting debut was this movie. Acting debut was this movie, but directorial debut was Dil Chahta Hai.
Yeah, Dil Chahta Hai. But this particular movie also was very different because in India, not many of us went to engineering colleges. Many of us went to school, college there. We were part of a musical band. Mm-hmm. But many, many of us, almost every single one of us did not pursue that as a career.
Yeah.
And how life comes in the way and how, pursuing a different career can actually take... its toll on your music. Jo aapka hidden rock star hai, wo chala jata hai. And how difficult it is for a group to come back together. So that movie was another path-breaking movie and I really liked it. I think we should leave with a song from that movie, right?
Why not, Brajan? And here's a song for you guys from the movie Rock On. Rock On 1 ki baat kare, 2 ki baare mein aur baat karenge because that actually is an unfortunate time it was released also.
Yeah.
Note banne ke time.
So suniyega Brajan, Rock On se ye gana Socha Hai, which actually is another different kind of, completely different kind of a rock song.
Yeah.
So suniyega, isi ke saath chode jayenge hum aapko. Next hour mein hazir ho jayenge with Geet Gaata Chal. Don't go anywhere. Keep it right here on 1310 AM and Radio D Hotties.
जंग क्यों